The pomegranate. The jeweled mine of the pomegranate, whose hexagons of honey the mouth would soon devour, but the eyes eat like a poem, lay hidden long in its hide, a diamond of dark cells, nourished by tiny streams which crystallized into gems. The seeds nescient of the world outside are of passionate teeth, prepared their passage into light and air, while tender roots and branches dreaming in the cell-walled hearts of plants made silent motions such as recreate both men and fruits. There, in a place of no light, shone that reddest blood, and without a word of order marshaled those grenadiers, gleaming without a sun, what art where no eyes were, till broken by my hand this palace of unbroken tears. To wedding bells and horns howling down an alley, muffled the married pair in closed caravan ride, and then the woman grown in secret, shining white, unclothed, mouth to mouth he holds his naked bride. And there are days, golden days, when the world starts to life, when streets in the sun, boys and battlefields of cars, the colors on a banister, the vendor slanting stands, send the pulse bounding on like the bursting of meteors. As now, the fruit glistens with a mighty grin, conquers the room, and though in ruin to its death, laughs at the light that wounds it, wonderfully red, so that its awful beauty stops the greedy breath. And can this fact be made so big of the body then? And is beauty bounded all in its impatient mesh? The movement of the stars is that, and all their light secretly bathed the world that now flows out of flesh.